Within fixed income, the first concept that we're going to learn is called bond valuation. So what is a bond per se? Like, what does a bond really mean? So it's a financial instrument. You can think of this as somewhat equivalent to investment into a fixed deposit, where you park in some amount at inception, you buy the bond, then every year you receive interest. Going forward, this interest would be referred to as coupon. So every year you receive the coupon amount. Then at the end of the life of the bond, which we'll be referring to as maturity, you get your original principal invested back. So you get the face value back and you get the last coupon back. So for example, let's say we have a bond which has a face value of 1000. This face value would be used for two purposes. First, this coupon amount, that means what cash flows you receive every year, is always as a percentage of face value. And second, this is the amount that the bondholder receives on maturity. So when the bond matures, this is the amount that you get back. So that's your face value. Then there would be a coupon amount, 10%. Now, this coupon will come with various conventions. For example, here I'm going to keep this as an annual coupon. Annual coupon means we will receive once a year. We can also have a semi-annual coupon. So how will you do the math? 1000 face value, 10% coupon. No matter what is the compounding frequency, whether it's annual, semi-annual, quarterly, doesn't matter. Every year, a bondholder is going to receive 100. But if it is annual, he just receive one payment of 100. If it is semi-annual, he'll receive two payments of 50 each. If it's quarterly, he will receive four payments of 25 each. So total amount is same, but when you receive that, frequency changes. So coupon 10% annual. Let's keep maturity of the bond as 4 years. Now, only based on this information, we can figure out what are going to be the cash flows on this bond. Okay, so cash flows are going to look like this. So I'm drawing a nice timeline here. Time zero, you don't have to write, just observe carefully. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So at time zero, the bondholder, he will have to buy the bond. To buy the bond, he will have to pay market value, which is not necessarily, which doesn't have to be not necessarily 1000. So it is possible that market value and face value of the bond is different. And we are very soon, we are going to learn to find out how to get this market value. But whatever is the market value, he pays for the bond. Then every year he will receive coupon. So he will receive four coupon payments. So 1000 into 10%. So every year he's going to receive 100. And at the end of the maturity, he will also receive that face 1000 back, irrespective of how much he paid at the inception. So it is possible that the bondholder bought the bond at 800, but on maturity he receives how much? 1000. So here he will receive this 1000 back. Now what we want to learn in the first half of the class today is how to calculate these market values of a bond. Are you following this? And then I'm going to write one sentence and you're going to write this along with me. Okay, so let's start writing it. All right, let's write it together. Market value of a bond is present value of future cash flows. Market value of a bond is present value of future cash flows discounted at. So let's underline, we need some lines below this, but let's look at what we've written. So market value of a bond, present value of all the future cash flows, not the ones we've already received. Present value, future cash flows discounted at. And now we have multiple ways of discounting. So first method, current YTM. YTM stands for yield to maturity. Very soon we'd learn what that YTM really means. So current YTM. Or a series of spot rates. A series of spot rates. Or a series of forward rates. Or par rate plus spot rates. These are some of the ways through which we can find out market value of a bond. Now we'll go step by step. So first we're going to learn how to do the valuation with YTM. So here's what I expect you to know so far. I expect you to know what is a bond, how does a bond work, and I expect you to know how to figure out the cash flows. So if I give you a face value, if I give you a coupon rate and maturity, do you think you can figure out the cash flows? Great. So now let's start doing the valuation. Let's say the YTM for this bond, YTM stands for yield to maturity. YTM for this bond, let me assign a random number. Let us say 12% per annum. All right, how do you want to think of this? You're new to the bond world. Let's assume you're an investor. You go to the bond market. You look at two rates, coupon and YTM. And it could be a little confusing. You want to buy the bond. And the $1 billion question you have for yourself is that when I buy the bond, am I going to earn 10% every year or am I going to earn 12% every year? Do I earn 10% or do I earn 12%? What do you think? What do you guys think? 10 or 12? Or let's do a poll. All of you together, how many of you think it is 12%? 1, 2. Just 5 and 2, 3 people there. All right. How many of you think it's 10? Okay, so to your surprise, all those of you who think it's 10, it is 12. It just looks like you're earning 10 because we're just getting 100 every year, right? So it looks like we are earning 10. But rule of thumb, and I'll prove you this, and it's very easy to prove because you'd learn that. But an investor always earns YTM, not the coupon rate. So when you purchase the bond, coupon was 10, YTM was 12. What's going to be your earning every year? Every year, your earning is going to be 12%. Just believe me for a few minutes, then we'll do the maths behind it. Okay. So this is what an investor is earning. And since this is so important, I'm going to write this here for you. An investor earns YTM. Okay, so let's start doing some math here. So we'll start valuing this bond. I'm going to write the characteristics one more time. Face value 1000, coupon 10%, maturity 4 years, YTM 12%. Okay, so I'm going to draw the timeline again. These are my cash flows, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. My cash flows would be 100, 100, 100, and 1000. How do we discount them backwards? This 100, we have to take backwards for how many years? 1 year. This 100 for how many years? 2 years. This will go on for 3 years. This 100 and this 1000 for 4 years, and then we will add up the numbers. Now, as far as TVM row is concerned, we don't have to do them individually. Why? Because can you observe we have four payments of 100 each, and then we have a face value or future value of 1000. We can just do it in one go. But when you discount them backwards, at what rate are we going to discount? At the rate of 12%. All right, so let's do it together. Second clear TVM. Future value 1000. The FU button on the calculator, future value 1000. Payment button 100. So 100 payment, 1000 future value. 4 should be N. 12 would be IY. And then you would say compute present value. 9. 939.25. So the bondholder who wants to buy the bond at inception, he's not going to pay 1000. Here, the market value that the bondholder is going to pay is going to be how much? 939.25. Are we okay with this? Now, let's try to think what's really happening here. So I'm drawing the timeline one more time. First question will take us a little time, but after a little practice, you guys will get good at it. Again, now time zero, we know what's happening. The bondholder is paying 939.25. This is the money that goes out. Then every year, he gets 100. In the final year, he gets 1000. This time, what I'll do is, I'll do the reverse calculation. Okay, so what kind of reverse calculation? We will insert these numbers into our calculator and we'll try to figure out what is the YTM. We'll see if that works. Now, there would be two ways of doing this. So, I'll show you both the ways so that you don't make the mistake. First, you can do this along with me. 939.25 negative present value. 939.25 negative present value. 100 payment, 1000 future value, 4N compute IY. 4N compute IY. Are we getting 12? Yes. So that's your YTM. Or the other way around. Second clear TVM, do this with me. 939.25, but this time let it remain positive. Let this number remain positive, present value. 100 negative payment. 100 negative payment. 1000 negative future value. 4 should be N, compute IY. What are you getting? 12. What you should not do. So don't do this. Do this. 939.25 negative present value. Do this. Second clear TVM. 939.25 negative present value. 100 negative payment. 100 negative payment. 1000 positive future value. 4N. Compute IY. That's a wrong answer. Same numbers, but sign changed. You got a wrong answer. One more type of mistake. Do this. Second clear TVM. 939.25 positive present value. Positive 100 payment. 1000 negative future value. 4N. Compute IY. Again, mistake. Why is this happening? That you're simply, there's a probability that you would mess up with the sign and the logic. Logic is very simple. This 939 is what I have to pay. And 100 and 1000 is what I'm going to receive. So the idea is the sign of these two amount should be same and it should be opposite of the sign of present value. So these are two groups of cash flow, one that you pay, one that you receive. The mistake happens if you keep present value and payment sign as same. Are you following what I'm trying to say here? So you just need to appreciate what is it that I receive and what is it that I pay. So this is what I pay, this is what I receive. So therefore, this is one group of cash flow. This is another direction of cash flow. So if you want to keep this positive, keep these two negative. Are you appreciating what's happening? Or this negative, these two positive. And if you take care of this, you'll not get your answers wrong. Got the logic? Now, another way of solving this. Look at the cash flow button on your calculator. Press that cash flow button. Then press second and clear work. Clear work is first column, last button. Second clear work. Now on your screen, it must be showing cash flow zero. So cash flow zero is at time zero. How much money is either coming in or going out? You tell me. 939 is going out or coming in? Going out. So cash flow zero, enter 939.25. This is cash flow zero. Is that okay? Then come on to cash flow one. How much is cash flow one? 100. Now this 100 is repeating how many times? 4 times. So I should keep frequency as 4. Frequency is 4? No. Why? Because I will have to take care of the 1000 as well. Correct? So what I'll tell my calculator, that this 100 gets repeated 3 times. So when I say repeated 3 times, I have taken care of these 3 cash flows. 100, 100, 100. Then come on to cash flow 2. And this time cash flow 2 should be how much? 1100. So when I insert 1100, I've taken care of this and I've taken care of this. Now once you've done this, press the IRR button on the right hand side. And now press compute. And see what you get. 12%. So what do we learn from this? What is this number IRR? IRR stands for internal rate of return. So few things that we're learning from this. One, YTM, yield to maturity in bond market, is actually same as this number called IRR, internal rate of return. And what is the meaning of internal rate of return? It simply means what you earn out of that investment. IRR is simply how much you are earning in percentage terms, what you earn. So YTM has the same interpretation. And to some extent, now we are able to prove that when, as an investor, I buy the bond, even though it looks like I'm earning 10%, how much am I really earning here? 12%. Why is that happening? Now, try to think of this logically. Are you absorbing? I would have earned 10%, like how it happens in a fixed deposit in a bank, if instead of 939, I would have bought the bond at 1000. So I buy it at 1000, I get 100, 100, 100, 100. I get 1000 back, I earn 10%, plain and simple. But I did not buy the bond at 1000, I bought the bond at 939. But at the end of 4 years, I give 939, at the end of 4 years, do I get 939 back or 1000? 1000. On top of that, that 10% is calculated on 939 or 1000? 1000, but I am putting 939. So what's happening is, on 939, I'm getting 100, not on 1000. Just think of it. 100 is calculated as a ratio to 1000, but money that's going out from my pocket is just 939. So every year I earn 100 on an investment of 939. Let's calculate that. Back of the envelope calculation. 100 as a ratio to 939. How much is that? 100 as a ratio to 939. Come on, how much? 10.64. So it looks like I'm earning 10.64. That would have been the case if at the end of year 4, they would have given me 939 back. But at the end of year 4, they're giving me that 60 extra. Are you following this? And this is how my total earning is jumping on to 12%. All right, now let's practice a bit on this. We'll do a total of 4 questions. Face value 1000, coupon 15%, maturity 4 years, YTM 12%. This is an annual coupon bond. Now, a semi-annual coupon bond where coupon gets paid twice a year. Face value 1000. Coupon rate 18% per annum, semi-annual. Maturity 2 years. 2 years. YTM 15%. Now, these are the questions where you have to figure out what is the bond value. So, calculate what's the bond value here. Calculate what is the bond value here. Then, these two questions will calculate what is the YTM. So, face value 1000. Market value 920, maturity 2 years, coupon rate 15%, find out what is the YTM. This is again an annual bond. Then semi-annual bond, face value 1000. Market value 870, maturity 2.5 years, all the maturity is in years, coupon 14%, figure out what's the YTM. This fourth quadrant question is the most probable from an exam perspective for CFA exams, not for FRM. FRM, this is too basic. Guys, are we done? All right, let's solve this together. Second clear TVM, you do this. All of you do this along with me, even if you got the answer right, it's good practice. So second clear TVM, 1000 future value, 150 payment, 4 should be N, 12 should be IY, and then compute present value. Now, present value, it will show a negative number. Doesn't mean it's negative. It just means it's showing an opposite sign. So how much is that? 1091.12. Now, I don't have to write that negative, so I'm going to get rid of it. So I'm just going to say value of the bond is 1091. So when someone needs to buy the bond, he'll have to pay 1091 and then he'll receive the coupons. Now, if you were a bond holder here, what are you earning every year? Are you earning 15 or 12? No, think carefully. Coupon is 15. Are you earning 15 or 12? 12. As an investor, you're always earning the YTM. How many of you got this right? Right, almost everyone, everywhere. That's great. This one gets a little tricky now. I'm going to write the keys, but you don't write because I'm going to make a mistake. You have to be alert, observe, and figure out where I'm making the mistake. 1000 future value, 90 payment, 90 payment, 4N. Sab ke sab galti kar raha hai. He's making all the mistakes. And 7.5 IY. How many mistakes have I made here? One. Two. One mistake. Three mistakes. Four mistakes. What did you say? You're a man of mistakes. None. Okay, how many of you think one? How many of you think two? Three. It seems you guys don't like me, is it? Three. Okay, four. Four mistakes. The answer is zero. No mistake at all. This is how this is to be solved. Now let's build a thought process on this. It's not difficult, it's simple, it'll come to you. In terms of cash flow, the timeline here looks different than how we built in the previous case. Here's how the timeline is going to look like. Once you learn to visualize timeline, it's really easy. This is time zero. This is now 0.5. Year one. Year 1.5 and year 2. Face value 1000, coupon rate 18%. So 1000 into 18%, how much? 180. So per year, I should get 180. But it's semi-annual. So if I get 180 per year, every 6 months, I get how much? 360? 90. Every 6 months, I get 90. So my cash flows are going to be 90, 90. And then again 90-90. That means my coupon amount got half for every payment, but I got coupon twice a year, correct? Then at the end of the tenure, I will also get what? 1000. So what should be my N in the calculator? My N should be number of coupons I am receiving. So are you receiving two coupons or four coupons? You're receiving four coupons. So your N is going to be four. But if you keep your N is four, then what is that 1N? Now your 1N becomes half of the year. Correct? That's how you have four semi-annual periods within your calculation. So your IY is 15% per annum. So for half of the year, your IY should be how much? 7.5. Correct? So in case if you're finding this difficult, I'm going to write down certain easy tricks for you. Whatever is the IY, you make it half. Whatever is the coupon, annual coupon, you make it half. So whatever rates that you see, you divide them by 2. Coupon rate, YTM, both, you divide them by 2. And whatever payment that you see, you multiply them by 2. That's how you handle the semi-annual question. Make sense to you? So now, let's do it on the TVM row. Let's figure out how much we get here. Second, clear TVM. Do this with me. Second clear TVM, come on, pick up some speed on it. 1000 future value, 90 payment, 4N, 90 payment, 4N, 7.5 IY, compute present value, 1050.23. Is that okay? Now, let's do this one. Second clear TVM, you can do this along with me. Just be alert, I can make a mistake. Second clear TVM, 1000 future value, 150 payment, 920 negative present value, 2 should be N. And then compute IY. How much? 20.25. How many of you got this right? Okay, again, almost everyone. Did you try doing this using cash flow function? Let's do it together, just for fun. So hit the cash flow button. Then say second clear work. Clear work is first column, last button. We need to press second clear work to delete if we have saved anything previously. So now on your screen, you have cash flow zero. So that becomes 920 negative, enter. Because to buy the bond, we have to pay $920. So 920 negative, enter. Then press downward arrow. Come on to cash flow one. How much are we receiving in year one? So we are receiving 150. So 150 positive, enter. Let the frequency remain 1, it's just a 2-year bond. Now come on to cash flow 2. And in year 2, we receive both. We receive 150 as well as 1000. So 1150 should be your cash flow. And then once you've entered that 1150 in year 2, hit the IRR button, say compute. You should get the same answer. Do you want me to repeat cash flow keys again? Yes, no? Alright, press the cash flow button one more time. Do you want me to help you locate cash flow button? Have you found it? Okay, then press second and clear work. Second is that grayish or yellowish button. Clear work is first column, last button. Then on your screen, press 920. Then in the last row of the calculator, search for sign switcher, plus minus. When I say plus minus, please do not use. Use the last row button, plus minus. Make it 920 and then don't forget to press the enter button, otherwise it will not get you the answer. Enter is important, it shows equal to sign after enter. Then press downward arrow, it brings you to cash flow 1. Once you are on cash flow 1, 1150, enter. Then on the right of the cash flow button, you would see IRR, I think after NPV. Do you see IRR? So press the IRR button. Then it shows IRR 0 maybe at the beginning. And then you would see a compute button on the top of the calculator. It's the first button on the calculator, first column, first row. So press that and it should get you 20.25. Is it working now, all of you? All right, the last one, which is the trickiest one, but it's the most fun. You can solve the last one if you know the logic of the second one, the one that I've done right above that. Okay, so observe now. This time I'm not going to make a mistake, but you never know. 870 negative present value. Correct? Then 1000 future value. 70 payment. Is that correct? 70 payment? Because your coupon rate is 14% semi-annual. So 1 year you're getting 1000 into 14%, that's 140. Half of 140 is 70. So 70 payment. It's a 2.5 year bond. So 5 should be N. So we've inserted all the data. Now compute IY. And how much is that? 10.47. And there you go, that's your answer. This is not the answer. Are you saying 10.47 is not the answer? Then you're saying it right. 10.47 is not the answer. Why? Because 10.47 is your IY. Look at previous question. In the previous question, what was your IY? 7.5. But what was your YTM? Look at this question here. IY was 7.5, but what was your YTM? 15. What do you have now? IY. So how do you get your YTM? So for a semi-annual bond, once you get that, you have to multiply this with 2. And then whatever number you get, that's your final answer. Following this, easy. All right, let's do a couple of more. But this time we'll only do semi-annual ones. Face value 1000. Coupon 10% semi-annual. Maturity 3.5 years. YTM 15%, compute present value. Face value 1000, market value 1090, maturity 4 years, coupon rate 12% semi annual, compute YTM. All right, let's do it together. Second, clear TVM. It's important you get used to this clear TVM business, because if you don't do it, especially in bond valuation, you're going to get answers wrong, because your calculator is going to store what you have used previously. So second, clear TVM. 1000 future value, 50 payment, 7N, 7.5 IY, compute present value. How much? 867.58. All right, next one. Again, second clear TVM. 1000 future value, 1090 negative present value, 8 should be N, 60 positive should be payment. I am again ensuring that sign of future value and payment is same, and sign of present value is opposite, right? Remember this part, that payment and future value is one group, present value is the opposite group. And once you've done that, then you compute IY, which is how much? IY 4.62, and then your YTM should be 9.5. How many of you got this right? All right, great. Last two questions now, then I'll give you a break. It's going to be slightly different version of the same question. Face value is 1000, coupon is 10%, maturity 4 years, YTM of 15%. I want you to solve this question, assume annual, but this time use a formula instead. Don't use the TVM row. Set up an equation and solve this. I just want you to build a thought process to look at this from an equation perspective. Same, face value 1000, coupon, okay, I'll keep it same just for fun, YTM 15, maturity 4 years, semi-annual. Again, you're going to build a formula to solve this question, at least set up an expression. That instead of TVM row, can we solve this with the help of a formula? All right. Let's see how to do this. Step number one, of course, you build a timeline so that you learn to visualize this. So time zero, it's a 4 year bond. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Once I buy the bond, every year I'm going to get coupon of 100. And at the end of the tenure, I will also get 1000. So these are my four cash flows. My job is to discount them backwards at the rate of 15%, each of the cash flow. So the equation looks like this. This first 100, when I want to discount it backwards, the formula for taking present value is 100 divided by 1 plus 15% raised to 1. Raised to 1 because we need to take it backwards for 1 year. Plus, because we need to add them up, 100 divided by 1 plus 15% raised to 2. 100 divided by 1 plus 15% raised to 3 and 1100 divided by 1 plus 15% raised to 4. So when you do this individually and add them up, your value would be same as otherwise what you'd get using the TVM row. So in fact, TVM row is using the same formula to get you the answer. Okay, so we'll experiment just for fun. We'll do it with formulas and with TVM row just to check if we get the same answer. So let's do it together. I'll show you a faster way of handling these type of questions. 100 divided by 1.15 equal to. So when I divide it with 1.15, it's anyways 1 plus 15% raised to 1, correct? So you have roughly what, 85 now on your screen? 86. Store that number in the first memory slot. Okay, now wait for me. Let that number remain on your screen. Look at the second number. It is 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 2. On your screen, we've already divided by 1.15 once. So if I take the same number and divide it with 1.15 one more time, I will get raised to 2, correct? So let's do it. So the number in your screen divided by 1.15 one more time equal to. And whatever you get, STO 2. Are you following this? STO 2 means store in the second memory slot. Now divide this number with 1.15 one more time. Divide this number with 1.15 one more time. Whatever you get now, STO 3. And divide this number with 1.15 one more time. Okay, but now wait for a minute. Once you've divided, press equal to and just wait. Now, once you have divided, what do you have? You have 100 divided by 1.15 raised to 4, correct? The number on your screen. But look at the fourth number. It is 1100. So what I can simply do is I can multiply this number with 11, correct? So my numerator automatically became 1100. So multiply the number on your screen with 11. Am I speaking Chinese? Are you with me? Is this making sense? Yeah, so multiply it with 11 and put this into fourth memory slot. And just add up these numbers. RCL 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. RCL 1 plus RCL 2, add them up. Tell me how much. 8.857.2125. All right, let's use the TVM row. Let's see if TVM row knows how to do it. Second clear TVM, 100 payment, 1000 future value, 15 IY, 4N, compute present value. Are you getting that 857? Yes. So you do it whichever way. But it's okay to use TVM. Of course, TVM is faster, but you should be able to visualize what formula was used in TVM. Why do we need the formula? When we go to advanced level of bond valuation, there would be certain calculations which we'll be able to handle only with formulas. So you need to know the TVM technique. You also need to know the formula technique. The second one gets a little tricky now. So time 0, time 4. But every year we'll have to break down into two parts because it's a semi-annual bond. So this becomes 0.5. 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5. In 4 years, how many coupons are we going to receive? 8 coupons. So my per year coupon is 100. So how much for every 6 months? 50. So 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50, 50. And what else do you receive? You receive 1000 at the end. And then how will you set up your equation? Observe carefully. This first 50 divided by 1 plus, help me, 7.5 or 15? 7.5. You take half of that YTM and raise to 1. If you've made, what was your N? Your N was doubled, correct? So 15 is for 1 year. 7.5 is for half year. So you cannot do the year half and rate half. Correct? You can't do that. So you've already reduced your rate to half. So your exponent is going to be 1. And in the same fashion, the second 50, so this is the first 50. The second 50 will be like this. 1 plus 7.5% raised to 2. In the same fashion, if I want to see how will I discount this 50, so this 50 will be like this. 1 plus 7.5% raised to 6. And in the same fashion, then finally, 1050 divided by 1 plus 7.5% raised to 8. And that's how we'll finally get the bond valuation. Let's do it on the TVM row. Second clear TVM. 1000 future value, 50 payment. 1000 future value, 50 payment, 8N, 7.5 IY, compute present value. 853.56. Enjoying this? All right, let's do a quick recap before I let you go for the break. So we are on to fixed income. We're just learning basics. This is ABCD of bond valuation. We first understood what is a bond. We understood terminology like face value, coupon, maturity, and YTM. YTM is what we earn. Then how do you take value of a bond? Here's the important sentence. Market value of a bond is present value of all future cash flows discounted at either the YTM or different type of rates, which we will learn soon. And then we jumped on to bond valuation. One trick that we appreciated in the process is that present, if I want to calculate YTM, then the sign of present value and sign of payment and future value as a group has to be opposite. Otherwise, my calculator will throw wrong answer. The logic behind this is present value is what I pay, but payment and future value is what I receive. And then if I'm dealing with semi-annual bonds, then my coupon becomes half, YTM becomes half, but maturity becomes, N becomes twice. That means for 4 years, N will become 8. And once we've done that, then in the final leg, we just understood how to set up equations. That's it. We haven't done much, but you deserve your break now.